Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Valentine's Day is this Friday, and while we're happy to celebrate love, much like the song goes, no romance without finance. So here to help us with that sometimes uncomfortable conversation of money and love is our resident finance expert, Jini Thornton.
Hey, good morning.
Oh, it's so good to have you here today.
And love this and money.
Love and money is so hard, but why is it so hard for couples to talk about money?
Well, you know, the main reason couples really fight about money is because we've come from different experiences with money. Some of us grew up with money, it was plentiful. Some of our families really, really struggled from the beginning.
Yes.
So we're coming from that. And we have different values about money.
Yeah.
What's important to you could be very different than what's important to your mate. Of course, debt is a huge issue, whether it was you had it before you got in your relationship or if you acquired it while you've been together.
Yes.
Debt is a problem. Money secrets is big. Money secrets.
Infidelity.
Yeah,
we'll get into that in a minute.
Uh-huh. Yeah. We're gonna talk about that in a minute. And of course, different spending priorities for your children. Maybe you're a spoiler, or maybe one of you wants your children to go to private school versus public school.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, borrowing or lending money to friends and family.
Right.
Huge issue.
Yeah, because some people don't consult. You mean, what, you got your mama, what? Like, well, yeah, it could be like that.
And creates huge problems.
It does.
For sure.
So if they're already fighting, because obviously we're trying to prevent that. If they're already fighting, how can they stop or cease the fighting and find a financial resolution?
Well, I want people to kind of step back and take a different approach. And you really have to stand in the shoes and understand why your mate feels the way that they feel.
Okay.
You know, why are they coming from the direction that they're coming from? Know each other's goals. You know, why are you working towards a particular goal? You know, what's important to you and what's important to your mate?
Mm-hmm.
Have scheduled times to meet about money.
Yeah.
This is huge, and people really should do this. And for those of us who are going to be fighting about money and we need to use our inside voices, I suggest people meet in public.
Ah.
Scheduled every second and fourth Tuesday or Wednesday or whatever it is, but have that rhythm.
Right.
Start out meeting
so
in public.
So you're like with a cup of coffee, so you really paid that much money on that? You really went shopping. Oh, boy, I can't wait to get up out of here. No, I'm just playing.
With that quiet voice.
Yes, though. Right.
Absolutely. With that quiet voice.
Right. It matters.
Yep.
Yeah.
And one thing people seldom do is know your mate's money strengths and weaknesses.
Mm-hmm.
And know yours too. And leverage the strengths with each other.
Yes.
Yeah, that's really important.
It really is. Your mate's money personality.
Right.
Because some people are hoarders, some people are spenders,
right.
Some people don't know what to do, or two people don't know what to do.
Right.
How do you help us?
Like if you know if your mate is outgoing, you also want to know what their money personality is. And they can range from, of course, the shopper, but shopper means you actually have an emotional reaction to shopping.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you actually love it. It makes you really feel good. The avoider, mm-hmm, doesn't want to open their bills, doesn't want to talk about money. You do have that saver, the hoarder. Saving is everything to them. You have the monk, and the monk is the giver. You know, the person who gets what that satisfaction actually from giving money.
I give away everything. You need some help, babe, I'm a cash app, $100.
But we understand why that can create some problems in relationships.
Right.
You have the risk taker, you know, someone who really wants their money to grow. And who I am is that security seeker.
You are.
Yeah. Like, that's everything to me. Most important is making sure I'm financially straight.
Yeah. Have you always been like that?
Always.
Really?
Well, my mother was like that, too, though.
Right.
So, again, that's all about that family experience.
How can you turn yourself into that person?
It's
that's
not
real
too late.
Talk. It's not too late.
Oh,
right. You have
not
to encourage people that it's not too late to change their money personality.
Absolutely.
Okay.
And you can have more than one, too, of course.
Right. Right.
Yes.
Okay. 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 So financial infidelity, that happens a lot.
I moved
this. I didn't tell him. I spent this. I didn't tell her.
Infidelity in and of itself in any relationship, we know why it creates issues, but people don't realize how serious financial infidelity is.
Yeah.
And it looks like everything from secret bank accounts, secret investment accounts, secret debt. You know, your mate doesn't know about debt that you have. Secret shopping, having packages delivered to work or to your friend's house. People do that a lot. But you have to understand it eats away at the fiber of your relationship.
Yeah.
And we're grown. We work every day. You want to be able to buy what you want to buy, do what you want to do. But you also have a responsibility to your relationship and your household, too.
Okay.
So you all have to learn how to manage that together.
Yes, yes. So, you know, a lot of folks are dating in the single life. And they get somebody they might like a little bit.
Right.
How soon do you talk about money?
Level of financial conversation depends upon level of relationship.
Okay.
So at the beginning, you just want to talk very generally at first. You know, maybe different family experiences. You know, you're not saying, what do you have and this is what I have. You don't want to get to that point. And then as you progress in your relationship, you want to kind of begin to pick up what you begin to talk about. Uh-huh. And please talk about more than just spending.
Okay.
Another thing too with that is look for the orange flags.
Now what are the orange flags?
Not red, but if you're dating someone and they never like to open their mail, or if you're dating someone and whenever you're with them, a relative is always calling them, asking them for money, mm-hmm. those are little warning signs.
Or you see 888-844-800 on the phone all the time.
Always going straight to voicemail.
Okay.
Straight to voicemail. They don't want to take those calls.
Right.
Those are what I call orange flags. So it doesn't mean that you need to run in the other direction, but it may require some conversation.
Yes.
For sure.
Oh, yes. 30-second answer. Those money meetings. Tell me the importance of that again.
Okay, money meetings, think about it like working out. If you worked out just every now and then, once in a while, you're not gonna achieve your health goal or your physical goal.
Yeah.
Money's the same way.
Okay.
You have to be committed.
Yeah.
A certain day and time that you're going to meet, whether by yourself, mm-hmm. with your mate, about your business, whatever that is, where you focus on money. No TV, no social media,
right.
Nothing else.
Awesome, so we making money moves.
Yes.
With the love of your life. Thank you, Jini. You always have a wealth of knowledge. Please make sure you follow her on Instagram, @JiniThornton.